Hello viewers, welcome to the another episode of the Today's GK program. Let's start with the previous day question. And the question was, consider the following statements with reference to walking leaves. Statement 1, they are insects that live in densely forested places and feed on plants. Statement 2, only male walking leaves can fly considerable distances. And statement 3, their arms and legs can regenerate. How many of these statements given above are correct? Only 1, only 2, all 3 or none? And the correct answer is option C, all 3. Recently, 7 new leaf insect species known as walking leaves have been discovered. Walking leaves, also called leaf insects, look very similar to leaves. They are insects that live in densely vegetated places and feed on plants, hence statement 1 is correct. Female walking leaves cannot fly, but males can fly short distances, hence statement 2 is also correct. The arms and legs of walking leaves can regenerate, hence statement 3 is also correct. These insects reproduce sexually with females laying eggs. Their natural range extends from islands in the Indian Ocean across parts of mainland South Asia and Southeast Asia to Papua New Guinea and Australia in the Western Pacific. Therefore, option C is the correct answer. Okay, now start today's session, and the question 1 is, consider the following statements regarding the Global Fund. Statement 1, it is a worldwide movement to defeat HIV, dengue and malaria. And statement 2, the funding primarily comes from the private sector. You have to select the correct statement with the help of the given options, and options are A1 only, B2 only, C both 1 and 2, or D neither 1 nor 2. And the correct answer is option D, neither 1 nor 2. Recently, Global Fund secured a deal to slash HIV treatment prices. The Global Fund is a worldwide movement to defeat HIV, TB and malaria and ensure a healthier, safer and more equitable future for all. Hence, statement 1 is not correct. It was set up in 2002. Governments, civil society, health workers and the private sector funds for this initiative. The funding primarily comes from the public sector with 92% of total funding from donor governments. Hence, statement 2 is also not correct. India joined the Global Fund as a donor in 2006 and pledged $25 million for the Global Fund's 7th replenishment covering 2023-2025. Therefore, option D is the correct answer. Okay, let's move on to the next question. In the context of Indian biodiversity, what is the IUCN status of Kakapo? Critically endangered, near threatened, vulnerable or endangered? And the answer is option A, critically endangered. Gene mapping almost all remaining Kakapo will help New Zealand's rare night parrot survive. Kakapo are remarkable and unusual birds found only in Aotearoa, New Zealand. They only breed every few years, triggered by the availability of certain forest foods such as the fruits of the native rimu tree. This bird suffers from diseases such as the fungal infection, aspergillosis, and many of their eggs are infertile. It is a large, nocturnal, flightless, leg-breeding parrot. It has a pale owl-like face. The IUCN status of Kakapo is critically endangered. Therefore, option A is the correct answer. Next question. Consider the following statements regarding the diving support craft A-20 ship. Statement 1. It is designed to undertake operational or training diving operations in harbors and coastal waters. And statement 2. It was built by Messrs. Titagar Rail Systems Limited or TRSL. Which of the statement or statements given above is or are correct? 1 only, 2 only, both 1 and 2 or neither 1 nor 2? And the correct answer is option C, both 1 and 2. Recently, Diving Support Craft or DSC A-20 Yard 325, the first ship of the 5 Diving Support Craft project, was launched at Titagarh, Kolkata onto Hooghly River. These ships are designed to undertake operational or training diving operations in harbors and coastal waters, hence statement 1 is correct. These ships are indigenously designed and built under relevant naval rules and regulations of the Indian Register of Shipping or IRS. DSC A-20 is built by Messrs. Titagar Rail Systems Limited, that is TRSL, hence statement 2 is correct. They are 30-meter long catamaran hull ships with a displacement of approximately 300 tons. Therefore, option C is the correct answer. Next question. Consider the following statements regarding the meningococcal disease. Statement 1. It is a viral disease. And statement 2. It causes the membranes that cover the brain and spinal cord to become inflamed. You have to select the correct statement with the help of the given options, and options are A1 only, B2 only, C both 1 and 2 or D neither 1 nor 2. And the correct answer is option B, 2 only. Recently, meningococcus disease outbreak in the United States can be life-threatening. It is a rare but serious bacterial infection, and bacteria called Neisseria meningitidis Hence, statement 1 is not correct. It causes the membranes that cover the brain and spinal cord to become inflamed. Hence, statement 2 is correct. The two most common types of meningococcal infections are meningitis and septicemia. Both types of infections are severe and can be deadly in a matter of hours. It can be spread from person to person by sharing respiratory and throat secretions, that is saliva or spit. Therefore, option B is the correct answer. Next question. Consider the following statements regarding the National Council of Education Research and Training or NCERT. Statement 1. It is an autonomous organization set up to advise the state on policies for qualitative improvement in school education. And statement 2. The Union Minister of Education is the president ex officio of the general body of NCERT. Which of the statement or statements given above is or are correct? 1 only, 2 only, both 1 and 2 or neither 1 nor 2? So the correct option is option C, both 1 and 2. Recently, the Indian government granted the National Council of Educational Research and Training or NCERT deemed to be university status. It is an autonomous organization set up in 1961 by the Government of India to assist and advise the central and state governments on policies and programs for qualitative improvement in school education. Hence, statement 1 is correct. The Union Minister of Education is the president ex officio of the general body of NCERT. Hence, statement 2 is also correct. The major objectives of NCERT are to undertake, aid, promote and coordinate research in areas related to school education. It also prepares and publishes model textbooks, supplementary material, newsletters, journals and other related literature. Therefore, option C is the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Bhu Ramdev Wildlife Sanctuary was recently seen in the news. It is associated with which of the following states? Karnataka, Rajasthan, Telangana or Chhattisgarh? And the correct answer is option D, Chhattisgarh. Recently, the Chhattisgarh High Court dismissed a public interest litigation or PIL that aimed to designate the Bhu Ramdev Wildlife Sanctuary or BWS as a tiger reserve. It is situated in the Kavardha district of Chhattisgarh. It is named after the famous 11th century Bhu Ramdev temple near the sanctuary. It shares a border with Kanha National Park in Madhya Pradesh, making it a critical tiger habitat in central India. This wildlife sanctuary is the origin of the Fane and Sankari rivers. The sanctuary is characterized by its lush green forests, rolling hills and the Makal range of the Satpura hills. Therefore, option D is the correct answer. Next question. Pulikkalli folk art was recently seen in the news. It is associated with which of the following states? Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Telangana or Kerala? And the correct answer is option D, Kerala. Recently, human tigers and leopards pranced about the street in a rollicking show of Pulikkalli to lend a carnivalesque finish to Onam celebrations. Pulikkalli or tiger dance is one of the folk art forms of Kerala. On the fourth day of Onam festival, artists paint their bodies like tigers with stripes of yellow, red and black and dance to the rhythm of traditional percussion instruments such as thakil, uduku and chenda. The Swaraj Ground in Thrissur district plays host to this carnival that has people appearing in various unique hues and masks. The main theme of this folk art is tiger hunting, with participants playing the role of tiger and hunter. Therefore, option D is the correct answer. Next question. Which of the following best explains Patulin? New galaxy, fungus, coral or plant species? And the correct answer is option B, fungus. Recently, a research team from the Tokyo University of Science, that is TUS, in Japan discovered a fungus that helps destroy a harmful food toxin, Patulin. Patulin or C7H604 is a toxic mycotoxin produced by several types of fungi. It harms a wide range of creatures including humans, mammals, plants and microbes. It can grow on damaged or decaying fruits, especially apples. It is responsible for various health hazards including nausea, lung congestion, ulcers, intestinal hemorrhages and even more severe outcomes such as DNA damage, immune suppression and increased cancer risk. Treatment of Patulin toxicity includes oxygen therapy, immunotherapy, detoxification therapy and nutrient therapy. Therefore, option B is the correct answer. Next question. Which one of the following best explains or describes the term preeclampsia? A. It is a condition that develops during pregnancy. B. It is a plant disease. C. It is an old age disease. Or D. It is a type of cancer. And the correct answer is option A. Recently, the study revealed that a liquid biopsy approach that measures DNA methylation levels in the blood may improve the detection of pregnancies at risk of developing preeclampsia at early stages. Preeclampsia is a serious blood pressure condition that develops during pregnancy. It typically develops after the 20th week of pregnancy. It can also affect other organs in the body and be dangerous for both the mother and her developing fetus. People with preeclampsia often have high blood pressure or hypertension and high levels of protein in their urine or proteinuria. Changes in vision, including temporary loss of vision, blurred vision, or light sensitivity. Therefore, option A is the correct answer. Next and the last question. Consider the following statements regarding the reinforced aerated autoclaved concrete or RAAC. Statement 1. It is a lightweight, bubbly form of concrete. And statement 2. It has excellent thermal insulation properties. You have to select the correct statement with the help of the given options. And options are 1 only, 2 only, both 1 and 2, or D neither 1 nor 2. And the correct answer is option C, both 1 and 2. Recently, more than 100 schools across England were ordered to close buildings because they were constructed using unsafe concrete known as Reinforced Aerated Autoclaved Concrete, that is RAAC. It is a lightweight, bubbly form of concrete that was used in roofs, floors and walls between the 1950s and 1990s. Hence, statement 1 is correct. It looks like standard concrete, but compared with the traditional reinforced material, which is typically denser, RAAC is weak and less durable. The material was favored in construction projects because of its lightweight thermal properties. Hence, statement 2 is also correct. It is made from combination of cement, lime, water, and an aeration agent. It helps maintain a comfortable indoor temperature. Therefore, option C is the correct answer. Okay, now it's time for the practice question. And the question is, recently the term Kappa picus was in the news. It is related to options are A. Viral disease, B. Invasive seaweed, C. Cotton ball worm, or D. Sea snakes. So that's it for today. Don't forget to answer in the comment section. Stay tuned for the next session. Till then, Jai Hind.